Well, it's seems to be back to winter again now because it's gone really, really cold. Now, I've seen a lot of posts on Facebook where people are offering challenges for their favourite albums, but I can't be bothered with any of that. My challenge throughout this lockdown malarkey is to actually get fit, finally. And so I've been going out every day, jogging, walking, running, trying to build up my stamina, cutting down on my food, and I've actually lost about nearly a stone in doing that, and I reckon I've got at least another half stone to go. So part of my routine is to say go out and do some running, and I'm building up to race up this hill non-stop, which I'm going to try and do today, which should be quite fun. Now, I do have an important thing that I carry with me, just to make sure I'm okay. So, at the top of the hill is a really old church called St. Helen's Church. This is in Hangleton. And when I get to the top, when I catch my breath, I'm going to show you something quite interesting about this church. So, here we go. And I will be recording what I'm doing, but I'll probably speed it up.
Damn. Oh, sorry, I couldn't quite make it. Oh, that is disappointing. Oh. Oh, really disappointing. Really disappointed in that.
Was very disappointing. I actually thought I could do it today. I got further than before, but I was about 100 yards short from the top. Hopefully eventually I'll be able to sprint up here no problems. But not too bad for a 58-year-old asthmatic, high blood pressure, torn shoulder tendon. So I shouldn't be too disappointed. Right, when I can get my breath back, I'll show you something interesting about this church. Whew. So this is St. Helen's Church in Hangleton, in Hove. Now this is the oldest church in the area. In fact, it was mentioned in the Doomsday Book in 1086. So it's really quite old. She had a family wedding here many, many years ago. So long ago that I did film it, but it was done on cine. So, the old Super 8 cine films. So, yeah, we got my sister got married here, and I got a cine film of her walking up here with my dad. Some very old gravestones here. And there's one particular which I'm going to point out in a moment, which is really quite sad. Very, very interesting though. This
this is the headstone of a 17-year-old girl who died in 1976. It says, loving and treasured memories of Cillian Mary Creese, who died 5th of September 1976, age 17 years. And the quote is, the Lord is my shepherd. Now, for those of you who don't know, this young girl unfortunately died because she fell off a float, a carnival float, along Brighton seafront. Now, we used to have Brighton seafront for many years. We had all different organisations dressed up in lorries and trucks in various themes. And it used to go, I think it might be from the King Alfred or somewhere, or Grand Avenue, all the way along the seafront and through the town and up to Preston Park. Well, unfortunately, this young girl apparently fell off one of these trucks, and which led to her death. So that is going back a long, long time. So it's, whenever I see this headstone, it's quite kind of, you know, you kind of turn to think, really, because I've been 2 years younger than her at the time, I think. Very sad. This one looks to be like the oldest one here. Well, the oldest one I can actually read, 1897. To be honest, I've always thought that graveyards are a bit of a waste. I've always thought land should be for the living and not for the dead. But there we go, that's my opinion. Well, I was wrong about that. The last one being the oldest stone here. This one, I just make out it says 1799. So that is really old. Probably got, yeah, prime position in front of the church. I suppose first come, first served. Really quite a magnificent one. It's the only one in the church that's granite and mosaic as well. So he probably had a few bob. This is Edward Vaughan Henley, LLD. I don't know what LLD stands for. His wife's here as well, 1922. So it's really quite pretty, this one. I say you can't take it with you, but you can certainly show that you had it. I think I'll give my my body to science, see what they make of it. What must be a child's grave? It just says Justine Gloria, precious baby of Roland and Gloria Strickland, died 1st of May 1976. So it doesn't say how old she was, but quite often you will actually get children's graves on the edges of the graveyards, like down at Hove Cemetery on the south side. There's a long line of children's headstones, which is quite sad to see. So there we go, that's St Helen's Church in Hangleton Hove, near to where I live. One of the oldest, in fact probably the oldest church down the southeast here, having been mentioned in the Doomsday Book way back in 1086. It's a fantastic church. Now, I'm not religious. Anybody who knows me knows I don't have a religious bone in my body, but I do like churches. I study churches, architecture of churches, doing part of my A-level art. I did St Mary de Hora
Anyway, yeah, a few years ago you could actually go into these churches because they were all left open. But unfortunately, the way of the world now is they have to lock them up because of the yobs coming in and stealing things. In fact, actually, a few weeks ago, a church in Brighton had all the lead taken off the roof, which is sacrilegious. I think that's the word. Just want to quickly show you this fantastic flint wall, which goes all the way around the church. Now, I have repaired walls myself, but I've never had a go at doing a flint wall. I believe it's a lime mix, which is like a putty mix. So, I do find churches, graveyards, quite relaxing actually. Kind of puts life in perspective. Acts like a little bit of therapy as well. So it's not meant to be sad, it's meant to be a celebration of these people here. And also giving that poor young 17-year-old girl a bit of a mention, who died in 1976. And the Hove Carnival floats, so even just mentioning her, I think it's worth it. So what I've got to do now is run home, and it's going to be a lot easier running home downhill than it was running uphill, although I didn't quite make it, but persevering with that. And I'm going to show you something else which is quite nice, which has been happening all over Hamilton. Quite touching actually, so bear with me and I'm going to show you something else. Well, the wind has been really bad on the recording, so you can hardly hear me speak, so I'm doing this separately. Now, what's been happening is in my staggers, walks and runs around the area, these toys have been showing up, and I think there's SpongeBob SquarePants there, and I believe what's happening is the local residents are putting these toys out for children to see, which is really quite nice. And they're mainly tied to lampposts, and such as this teddy here, who's doing his bit. Don't know if he's going to last throughout the rain. Looks a bit frightening actually, I suppose, in one respect, but he's doing his best. And something personal the residents are doing in the area. Yeah, we're not very happy about him. Actually, two things I'm not very happy about. One of them is, as I was running down this hill, which as I said is a lot easier than running up. So as I was running down, there's somebody running up, and he looked a little bit older than me. Not much, but maybe the same age. So I'm running down. Don't forget, I couldn't make it all the way up. I'm running down, he passes me, 2 metre distance, and I thought I'd see how far he goes. And he got right to the top. Yeah, I forgot to say about that, at the beginning of that shot, that man with the dog. Why don't people keep dogs on their lead, on the lead? Because as I was coming down, this blinking dog, yet again, comes up to me. Okay, he didn't do anything, any harm, but I'm kind of walking around, coming up, sniffing around my ankles. What do you have to say to the owners? I'm speechless. What do you have to say to these owners who do not control their dogs? If there's somebody around, put the bloody lead on the dog. Because I'll tell you, one day, I'm not cruel to animals, one day I'm going to give a dog a real kick up the arse. Because that's, I mean, it's not the dog's fault, I know, but I should kick the owners up the arse. That's what I should do. I shall kick the owners up the arse. I'll get arrested, lose my taxi licence, become unemployed, can't drive. No, I should do what I do. I'll just give them the dirty stare. So if you're watching this and you're a dog owner, please remember to keep your dogs on a lead when there's other people around, because not every person is a dog lover. I like dogs, but I'm not a dog lover. Sorry, Mum, I do like Willow, but I don't like other people's dogs. mind you, Willow can be a challenge sometimes.